angel who talked with me. What are these? My Lord, he said. Do you not know what these are? No, my Lord. I replied. Then he said to me, this is the word of the Lord to Zerubbabel, not by might, nor by power, but by my spirit, says the Lord Almighty. What are you, mighty mountain? Before Zerubbabel, you will become level ground. Then he will bring out the capstone to the shouts of God bless it. God bless it. Then the word of the Lord came to me, and the hands of Zerubbabel have laid the foundations of this temple. His hands will complete it. Then you will know that the Lord Almighty has sent me to you. Who dares despise the days of small things? Since the 7 eyes of the Lord that rage throughout the earth will rejoice when you see the chosen capstone in the hand of Zerubbabel. Again, if you're watching us online, I'm called Pastor Ishmael. Jesus is Lord and Savior. My interpreter is called Pastor Steve. You are following us from the River of Grace Apostolic Ministry. You are based in Kibera. We invite you. You can join us physically, or when you're far away, please be blessed by the message of the word of the Lord.
Ukiketi chini ya upande wa Roho Mungu,
you don't qualify to walk in confusion.
Haifai utembee ukichanganyikiwa.
You qualify to walk in the light of the glory of God.
Unahitimu kutembea kwa mwanga ya utukufu wa Mungu.
Blessed be the name of Jesus.
Asifiwe Yesu.
The anointing brings light.
Upako leta mwanga.
You can find that when you read the story of the Exodus, the crossing of the Red Sea in Exodus chapter 14.
Tapata hiyo kusoma kitabu cha Kutoka 14 wana wa Israeli wakivuka
Israel. Israel had been brought out of the land of bondage.
Wana wa Israeli walikuwa wametolewa katika nchi ya utumwa.
And they were crossing through the sea.
Walikuwa wanavuka bahari ya Shamu.
And the Bible says that ahead of them was the sea.
Inasema mbele yao kulikuwa
and behind them was the army of Egypt following after them. You know, that was a day that a crucial decision had to be made. And Moses knew that if we shall go back to bondage, then we shall go back to the land of Egypt. Our destiny shall be no more. And the promises of God concerning our lives shall be vain. And the promises of God and the wonders of God that we saw in Egypt shall all be thrown under the breach. And if we shall go forward, there is the water waiting for us. We shall sink over the water.
Then
we can perish and the whole nation comes to an end. A decision had to be made. And the power of the Spirit of God was needed to make the decision. And the Bible says, God spoke to Moses. Told him, stretch forth your hand. And when he stretched forth his hand, the sea was divided. And the word of God says that the pillar of the cloud of God that was behind them that was in front of them went and stood behind them. And that became the glory of God. And ahead of them was the wind blowing to create way in the sea. And the Bible says that the cloud of glory that was behind them became a light to them in the night. Became a light to them in the night. Can you imagine that happening the way it happened? It is a night time. They are walking through the sea of impossibility. They are walking through a path that they have never walked through before. Yet the the Spirit of God which was with them was lighting their path, throughout the night. And the same cloud of glory, the Bible records, it became a gross darkness to the Egyptian camp. So that as they pursued Israel, they were walking through darkness and darkness and confusion and darkness. I declare to your life, if the anointing of the Spirit is upon your life, you shall walk through light and through light and through light and through light in Jesus' name. And if there is any demonic power that is pursuing you to destroy your destiny, I declare to them that the same light of the Spirit which is upon your life, it shall be a gross darkness to them in the name of Jesus. Hautachanganyikiwa ni wao watachanganyikiwa. Wewe utatembea kwa mwangaza wa uwezo wa Roho Mtakatifu, bali wale ambao wanakufuata kwa kadiri wakaweze kuharibu hatima yako na wakaweze kuharibu maisha yako. Maandiko yanasema ya kwamba utukufu wa Bwana ulifanyika kuwa giza kwa upande wa wana Misri na ukafanyika kuwa mwangaza kwa wana wa Israeli. I decree to you, utatembea katika mwangaza katika jina la Yesu Kristo. You shall walk in light in Jesus' name.
Utatembea kwa mwangaza katika jina la Yesu.
I said you shall walk in light in Jesus' name.
Utatembea kwa mwangaza katika jina la Yesu.
You shall not make decisions that will throw you into the sea.
Utachukua mwuzi ya maji kukuangamiza.
Neither shall you make decisions that will take you back to bondage.
Wala utachukua mwuzi ya maji kurudisha kwa utumwa.
As from today,
kuanzia leo,
I declare to you,
nakutangazia,
you shall make decisions that will elevate you to the next level.
Utachukua mwuzi ya maji kutupiga kwa utumwa.
In the name of Jesus Christ, may God anoint your decision.
Mungu akupatie mwuzi yako.
If you are a husband,
kama wewe mwanaume,
God may anoint your decision. If you are a wife, may God anoint your decision. If you are a businessman, may God anoint your decision. If you are a head of a department in a school, may God anoint your decision. If you are a civil servant, may God anoint your decision. May your eyes be enlightened by the Spirit of God. Say praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Say hallelujah.
Amen.
Say I will not walk in darkness. I will walk in the light. When you walk in the light, with the light of God be upon our spirit. The Bible says, we shall only trust and obey. We shall only trust and obey. We shall only follow. In the name of Jesus, and the light of God is a teacher. There are things that one man cannot teach you properly. There are things that school cannot teach you properly. There are lessons you will never learn in Taifa Hall or in Yayo 2. You will never learn them. There are lessons learn in a lecture hall. Blessed be the name of Jesus. But when you sit under the anointing of God, the Bible says, let me share with you this, come on. 1 John chapter 2 verse 27. For the anointing you have received from him teaches us all things. Did you get what the Bible says? I am a good preacher. I'm a good teacher of the word of God. I will not teach you all things. Hallelujah. I am be very educated. But I cannot teach you all things.
And
the Bible says, when the Spirit of God is upon your life, the anointing of God will teach
yale yote.
Hallelujah.
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 Amen.
The moment the Holy Spirit descends upon your spirit,
wakati Roho Mtakatifu imewatia juu yako,
you ought to sign out of the class of fools and join the class of the school of the spirit.
Inafaa utoke kwa kanisa kwa class ya wachinga na uingie kwa class ya Roho Mtakatifu.
Where we are taught all things.
Church of mission with the
I said all things pertaining godliness. All things pertaining life. All things pertaining the kingdom of God. All things pertaining ministry. All things pertaining family. All things pertaining heaven. Oh, I love the Spirit of God. He's a teacher. Glory be to Jesus. May you never walk in foolishness. May your head be opened up.
Hallelujah.
Before I was in Nairobi, I was a rural preacher.
Wakati nilikuwa kijiji, nilikuwa mwalimu mhubiri wa kijiji.
There was a woman I saw in the village many years back.
Kuna mama niliona kijijini miaka mingi iliyopita.
She was very foolish.
Alikuwa mkumbavu.
Can I tell you why?
Nikwambia nini?
She used to dry maize.
Alikuwa na nika mahindi
in her blanket.
Kwa blanket yake.
Simujinga hii. Ile blanketi unajifunika nayo na mzee. Anafanya nini? Ananika nini? And when she went to the river to fetch water,
akienda kutafuta maji,
she had a big sufuria.
Alikuwa na sufuria kubwa.
That was the same sufuria used to fetch for fetching water.
Yes, pia alikuwa anatumia kwenda kuchota maji.
And for watering cows, the same sufuria.
Na hata kumpa ng'ombe maji ya sufuria.
And cooking ugali, the same sufuria.
Hata kupika ugali hiyo moja.
And the worst.
Mbaya sana.
She used the same sufuria to bathe children, not even to bathe herself.
Alikuwa anaitumia hata kuosha watoto na hata kuoga.
That was poverty of. But when she got born again.
Alipookoka.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
When she got born again.
Alipookoka.
I don't know where she was taught.
Sijui alifundishwa wapi.
But the Holy Spirit.
Lakini Roho Mtakatifu
taught her all things.
Alifundisha vitu vyote.
Even how to arrange your house.
Alifundisha kupanga nyumba yako.
Even how to wash the hands of your husband before eating.
Alifundisha kunawisha mzee kabla ya kula.
Even how to behave in your bedroom.
Hata vile unafaa uchibebe kwa nyumba yako ya kulala.
Even how to wash your socks every day or every weekly, no matter how many times you wash.
Hata vile unafaa uchafishe socks zako.
Even how to dress. Some of us didn't even know how to dress.
Hata jinsi ya kuvaa wengineza tu kwa jua jinsi ya kuvaa.
Nowadays we stand before you admire as you are well organized.
Msikilize tunavaa mbele yenu naona tumejipanga sana.
Blessed be the name of Jesus.
Atukuzwe Yesu.
Blessed be the name of Jesus.
Atukuzwe jina Yesu.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Young sisters, the Holy Spirit need to teach you all things.
Wasikilize wadogo, Roho Mtakatifu yafaa afundishe vitu vyote.
Even how to dress. When you go home and then
ata jinsi ya kuvaa ukiwa nyumbani.
You are before your mother-in-law or your father-in-law.
Uko mbele ya mama ama baba ya wazazi wa bwana yako.
And you have a very long skirt, but the skirt is cut 70%.
Na umevaa skirt imefika chini lakini imekatwa
only 30% is a cloth, 70% is a curtain, just waving this side and waving that side.
Kidogo tu ndio imefunika ile kubwa inaenda hivi.
And you say this is how things are done in Nairobi.com. Foolishness. You need to sit under the anointing of God.
Wasema hivi ndio vitu ufanye like ni ujinga na faa ukae chini ya mafundisho bingu.
We may not teach you all things.
Hatutakufundisha vitu vyote.
There are some people that are struggling with petty things.
Kuna watu wanaenda vitu dogo.
You have been born again for 7 years, but you still don't know how long a skirt ought to be.
Umekaa kwa ukovu miaka saba, bado hujui skirt inafaa ifike wapi.
You're saying my dress, my choice.
Nasema kuvaa kwangu uchaguzi wangu.
You need to be anointed by God.
Nafaa upakwe na Mungu.
You need to be taught by the Holy Spirit.
Nafaa ufundishwe na Roho Mtakatifu.
Blessed be the name of Jesus.
Atukuzwe jina Yesu.
Can I teach what my bishop taught me?
Nafundishe kenye askofu yangu alinifundisha.
If you go to a church where people are struggling how to dress, especially sisters.
Niambia ukienda kwa kanisa penye wasichana wana shida ya kuvaa.
Ask the choir to sing a song.
You know
this song which says, lift Jesus higher. Ask them to lift Jesus higher, and lower the Satan to the lowest. After this, I send you to your wardrobe. And measure your clothes one by one. And sing the song and see how much that cloth can take Jesus higher. And how it can take Satan lower. It cannot lift Jesus higher and take Satan lower. Leave it alone. Don't even donate it. Because you want everyone to lift Jesus higher and take Satan lower. That is the teaching of the anointing. Say hallelujah.
That is
the teaching of the anointing. Say hallelujah.
Teach you
very many small petty things which are necessary in this life. The anointing teaches all things. Lift up your hand, child of God, every one of you. Say, as from today, I will not walk in ignorance. I will not demonstrate foolishness. I open my heart to the teaching of the Spirit of God. To teach me all things.
Hallelujah.
Teach me character.
Yes, Lord.
Teach me how to love people.
Hallelujah.
Teach me how to serve people.
Yes, Lord.
How teach me how to live a life of dignity.
Yes.
I declare to my life, I will not walk in foolishness. In my character, in my life, I will lift Jesus higher. I will glorify the name of the Lord. In the name of Jesus, the Son of the living God.
Yes, Lord.
May the sons and daughters of this ministry be people who are taught the ways of God properly. The Holy Spirit is a teacher. He has taught me so many things. He has taught that one day that there are some men who went to Job. And they worked with elderly men. They went to Job, to Job in the Bible. And there was a man who was young among them. And they listened to elders talking. And it seemed that the elders did not speak wisdom. And it seemed that I thought that wisdom is in age or in grayness of air or in academic degrees. But it proved that true wisdom is in the spirit of a man. The spirit of God is called the spirit of wisdom. Hallelujah.
Amen.
May you be anointed by wisdom in Jesus' name. Number two, the Spirit of God is compared to oil. Because oil is used to polish. I love this. Oil is used to polish. You put on some shoes. When they are dusty, what do you do? You polish them. Do you have some metal, some items that are made of metal? Before they are used, they are painted and polished. When something is polished, it becomes clean and perfect. It shines, it becomes attractive. That is the work of the Holy Spirit in the life of a believer. God does not use rugged things. God does not use things that are left helter-skelter. God is the King of Kings and is the Lord of Lords. And if you visit the house of any king under the sun, bear me witness, you will meet one standard, it is called excellence. Blessed be the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Blessed be the name of Jesus. And so God is telling Zerubbabel, you want to build my house, you
have
to be polished. Your work has to be polished. Your character has to be polished. Your skill has to be polished. Blessed be the name of Jesus. I decree to your life in Jesus' name. This house will be a polishing house. I said this house will be a polishing house. In my village, if a girl goes to marriage and she doesn't carry on herself properly, they will abuse her mother. They will call her mother names. They will not believe the girl, they will believe the mother. In the same way, when we see people carry on their self, in shame, we need to ask ourselves, which house do they come from? Which anointing do they sit under? Who is their pastor? Sometimes I ask people that join my church. I say, you are talking like this. Do you go to any church? And who is your pastor? Luckily enough, I know so many pastors in the city.
And
when they discover I know their pastor,
but
I will call your pastor. You need to be polished. I said you need to be polished. Your words have to be polished. Office, the way I speak to people in my office is totally different from how other people talk. Serving in the same office, the same job description, the same years of experience, but when the Spirit of God is upon your life, there is a level in others. Kama haujafika hapo, rudi ukamtafute Roho Mtakatifu. Kama bado unafanana fanana na watu, unaongea kama watu, fikira zako ni kama watu, enda rudi hapa umtafute. Maana ukikutana Roho Mtakatifu, he will polish your life. He will polish your language. Amen. He will polish your character. He will polish you. He will polish your thinking. He will polish your mind.
Nasema kama ushapokea Roho Mtakatifu, basi atarekebisha vile unaongea, vile unafikiria, vile unajibeba, vile unawasiliana na watu, ataiweka ipasavyo. Hiyo ni kazi ya Roho Mtakatifu.
When you are anointed, even when you speak in a business meeting, your words and your mindset is different.
Kama umepakwa, hata ukiongea kwa kongamano au kwa biashara, neno lako na vile unaongea itakuwa tofauti.
Ukishakuwa na mkutano na watu mpaka watu wanaongea unashangaa, huyu mtu anaongea hivi kwa mkutano, huyu ametoka Kenya ama huyu anatoka wapi huyu? Na huyu anakaa hii Nairobi huyu. Kwa sababu hoja ambayo anatoa ni hoja bichi. Hata secretary anashangaa hii. Sasa unaambiwa uchukue minutes. Unaandika nini? Lakini kuna wale ambao wapakwa mafuta. Akianza kuongea, unaona secretary anaandika the meeting decided. The meeting decided. The meeting, he is the meeting. What is the secret? It's not because they have masters, no.
Polishing.
Polishing.
Upako.
Polishing.
Upako.
Polishing.
Upako.
Polishing.
Upako.
Polishing.
Upako.
If you sit under this grace, you shall be polished in Jesus' name. I said you shall be polished in Jesus' name. You shall never go anywhere and end up a reject.
Yes.
You shall never be a reject. In the name of Jesus. Glory be to the name of Jesus. The book of Daniel chapter 3.
Kitabu cha Daniel mlango wa 3.
Verse 1 down to 3. Somebody read for us.
Mustari,
Daniel chapter 6.
Daniel mlango wa 6.
There is an example of a polishing of the anointing of the Holy Spirit here.
May.
Verse 3. Daniel chapter 6 verse 3.
Daniel.
Now Daniel was so distinguished among the chief magistrates and the satraps and by the exceptional qualities that the king planned to set him over the whole kingdom. King James Version says that Daniel demonstrated the spirit of excellence, that the spirit of excellence was upon Daniel,
yes,
that the king planned to set him up above other administrators so that the kingdom might not suffer loss. Now listen to this. Daniel was not preaching here in this context. He was an administrator. He was a governor.
Alikuwa gavana.
He was a leader.
Alikuwa kiongozi.
And the Bible says,
Biblia sema,
that they looked at everything to entangle him or to accuse him, but they never found anything.
Waliangalia vizu zote ambao unaenda kumstaki nayo, lakini hawakupata.
They never found everything.
Hawakupata chochote.
They called, they went to DCI, they found Daniel's record is clean.
Walienda kwa DCI, wanapata Daniel na makosa.
Ethics and anti-corruption, they found Daniel's record is clean.
Kwa watu wa corruption, wanapata ana makosa.
The college where he trained, they found the record of Daniel is clean.
Kenya alienda college, wanapata maisha yake ilikuwa sawa.
Blessed be the name of Jesus.
Hatuku jina Yesu.
And then they asked themselves, what is the secret of this man?
Wakatuliza, je, siri ya huyu nini?
And they answered,
wakajibu,
the spirit of excellence.
Roho ya utimilifu.
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 He was excellent in all things.
Alikuwa amehitimu kwa vitu vyote.
I decree to you in Jesus' name.
Natangaza mashauri ya kila mtu.
You shall not be a mediocre.
Hautakuwa mtu hivi.
You shall not be a failure.
Hautashindwa.
But you shall be excellent.
Lakini utatimu.
Let the spirit of excellence be in operation in this house.
Roho ya utimilifu ikae katika hii nyumba.
Let the spirit of excellence be in operation in your business.
Roho ya utimilifu ikae katika biashara yako.
Let the spirit of excellence be in operation in your ministry.
Roho ya utimilifu ikae katika mbele huduma yako.
In the name of Jesus.
Katika jina la Yesu.
In the name of Jesus.
Katika jina la Yesu.
He was a polished man.
Alikuwa amehitimu.
We are in electioneering period.
Tuelekea uchaguzi.
This is my prayer for the country.
Hii ndio ombi langu kwa nchi.
That God,
Yakuwa Mungu,
may give us leaders,
atupe viongozi,
who have been polished by the anointing of the Spirit.
Wenye wamepakwa na Roho Mtakatifu.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
People whose hearts and characters have been polished. Oh, may God give us a Daniel in Kenya in Jesus' name.
Wale wenye roho yao imepakwa, hey, Mungu atupe viongozi kama Daniel katika nchi ya Yesu.
It is possible, that's my prayer for this country.
Yawezekana hiyo ni ombi yangu katika nchi.
We are tired of being led by con men.
Tumechoka kuongozwa na watu.
We are tired of being led by people who are full of tribalism, thieves and murderers.
Tumechoka kuongozwa na watu wenye wakuna kabila.
In the name of Jesus,
Katika jina la Yesu,
the Son of the Living God,
we
speak into the air and the environment of this country right now and this year.
Tunaenda kwa anga hii chukai miaka.
But God Almighty,
Mungu
Not men that because they come from our tribe, no. Not men that because they are learned, no. Not men that because they have a big following, no. Not men that because they have money, no. But men and women whose hearts, whose lives, whose characters have been polished by the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
And so shall it be.
And
so shall it be. The Spirit of God polishes people, polishes leaders, polishes character, polishes ministers, polishes talented people. May this be a house of polishing in Jesus' name. May this be a ministry of polishing in Jesus' name. Wherever you serve the community, may people ask,
what do you listen?
Which chapter he goes? May people ask,
what do you listen?
Who is his pastor?
May
people ask,
what do you listen?
Where does he come from?
And I talk happy.
Not because you have a weird character, but because the spirit of excellence which was upon Daniel becomes upon your spirit. Now, the Spirit of God does not only polish you and leaves you there, no. Once he has polished you, he elevates you. He polishes you and elevates you.
Pray your mama to pack your balloon across the apple. And I could pack her, Nana Quinoa. And I could pack her, Nana Quinoa.
No, Gila, mama. When they noticed that Daniel was a polished man, the king decided, under the inspiration of the Spirit, to promote him.
When you put your Daniel on the pack, Daniel on the pack, now find me a more, Chimia, Shamisha, and Gratifo, Kuminoa.
His service became more favorable than others. That means that the oil of God polishes you and also favors you. Psalms 45 verse 7 and 8 says, because you love righteousness and hate wickedness, therefore the Lord your God has anointed you with the oil of gladness and favor. Look at how the Bible says, because you love righteousness and hate wickedness, for you to be favored by God, righteousness is a precondition. You must love righteousness and hate wickedness before you are promoted by God. The condition of your heart is a precondition.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because you love righteousness,
and
hate wickedness, therefore the Lord your God has anointed you with the oil of gladness and elevated you above your companions. I declare for your life that your heart
will
love righteousness. Will love righteousness. And that your heart will hate wickedness. And therefore the Lord your God, will elevate you, will favor you, will people pay for everything. There are some things you'll earn by favor.